Hey guys, Sifu Jason. Welcome back. And I know I've been like missing in action for a while and people have been emailing me. I'm okay. I did, however, get abducted by aliens. And it was a weird experience. I mean, they were just playing music the whole time. Oddly, Backstreet Boys. I don't know what was up with that. And some Milli Vanilli. It was horrible. I don't want to talk about it. But seriously, we're back. And a couple of things about myths in Wing Chun that are really holding us back in Wing Chun. The first big myth in Wing Chun, I think, is regard to the footwork. So in terms of application, people confuse their footwork and they have this kind of step and drag mentality. And I think that's a bad translation. It should be step and slide. But nevertheless, for practical purposes, the Wing Chun footwork is a lot more like boxing footwork than we're often led to believe. Now, clearly, the Wing Chun fighter has to be cognizant, has to be prepared to deal with the varieties of surfaces that they may be fighting upon and the environment. Remember, you're not just fighting your opponent or opponents, you're also fighting the environment. There's gonna be hard objects everywhere. There's gonna be stairwells, curbs, and there are a lot of things that go into that. So you don't wanna get a type of footwork that's bouncing too much. So when I say boxing a lot, people will then say, well, the footwork is very bouncy. It's not. Actually, if you watch boxing footwork, when they don't have contact with people, they're a little higher in their stance and they're very fluid, as should Wing Chun people be. I don't know where this thing comes from that your Wing Chun footwork needs to be engaging the four-wheel drive all the time. Now, if you are not a truck driver or you don't have a pickup truck or something, a four-wheel drive, when you engage it, you'll notice that vehicle just literally drop. That's what happens to the fighter when they get inside a clinch or some kind of a tie-up, is you drop, your weight gets more rooted. That does not mean that you have to be rooted and virtually dragging your feet like you're some kind of Frankenstein monster on the outside. If you're in a free movement, you need to be moving rapidly and smoothly, and that is still Wing Chun footwork. And I would even say that the Wing Chun footwork over against boxing is better if you use boxing as kind of a way to gauge it, because you're ambidextrous, you can continue to switch leads. It gives you better ability to change angles and to face perhaps multiple opponents. So that is gonna be an advantage of the Wing Chun footwork against boxing. But Wing Chun footwork and boxing are not, repeat, not antithetical. They are very, 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 very similar. And if you watch good boxing footwork, it's step and slide. It's a shuffling type footwork, and it keeps you in good position to hit all the time. You're always able to punch. And the same thing should be going on for the Wing Chun fighter. So get rid of this foolish notion that you should have your weight so far on your rear foot that you can't move freely. That is a bad interpretation, we believe. That leaves you a sitting duck. Plus, it leaves your chin way up in the air. That's another myth. We'll get to that in another video. But for today, I think boxing and Wing Chun footwork are very, very similar. Of course, there's going to be some differences because of the environment and the terrain that Wing Chun's ready to fight on. I think Wing Chun has a more four-wheel drive type of structure to it than boxing does. and that would be the major difference. So Wing Chun is an off-road vehicle that can be driven on the highway. If you're only off-road, you can't drive on a highway, and you need to drive on a highway, you have a problem, right? So looking at that, you apply that to your Wing Chun footwork, and I think you'll be very, very, very grateful for that type of training in your life, because no one ever goes, man, I just wish I hadn't been able to move so well. That's not gonna happen. You know, why would you complain the fact that you were able to outmaneuver your opponent? Now, one objection that comes up to is that the Wing Chun fighter should always be going forward, and you know, never, that's a tactical misapplication, and that bleeds into the footwork issue, is that a car, as my Sifu Tony Massengill says, a car that doesn't have reverse is a bad car. You have a problem with that vehicle. You do need to step back and step to angles. You just have to. That's just a foolish notion. It's a tactical, it's such a tactical nightmare to just have only one direction. If you look at Mike Tyson as a barometer for that, you look at how evasive he was, and he was a pretty strong guy, so a pretty powerful guy. And if Mike Tyson had to work on making sure he was elusive, then so do we. Okay, so we're gonna be used to footwork and be able to angle. And so in that case, I think the Wing Chun footwork is very similar to boxing and a little bit better if we use it the right way. Okay, so that big myth that Wing Chun footwork is like a ball and chain and it's antithetical to boxing is not true. It's just simply a misinterpretation of the way the structure is built, which I'll clear up one more thing, one more thing is that when you're looking at the forms are structural foundations of applications. You are not going to fight like you're doing the form, okay? Any more than a boxer is skipping rope and hitting a speed bag while he's boxing. Those are drills that he uses to become more fluid, get better time, and keep his hands up. Well, in the form, we're moving in such a way to develop the right body feel and structure that we can use as a standard so that we don't just run off the reservation and become, you know, antinomian, where we're just lawless and there's anarchy. So the forms are valid and they're giving you the structural foundation of that movement, but you're not tied to moving like that in a form any more than a boxer that first comes in the gym is tied to have to do the same thing when he's boxing that he's doing in training, okay? So hopefully that works for you, and hopefully it obliterates, it blows up, and it demolishes this really painful myth that Wing Chun footwork and boxing footwork have nothing to do with each other, because it's making Wing Chun the performance of it very difficult because people have bad footwork. And as we like to say here, good footwork can and will beat every attack. It simplifies things big time, okay? So hopefully that changes your mind and opens your mind to the possibilities that Wing Chun has. A great book on that, again, I'm mentioning footwork in every one of my books. My Sifu Tony Massengill has a book, Wing Chun Unchained, that really broadens your understanding of what the Wing Chun system really ought to be, and it dispels a lot of those myths and a lot of the hyper-traditionalism. So check those out, and thanks for watching. It's good to be back, and I'll catch you guys next time.